Hello everyone, welcome back to Chen Design Channel. Today's video, we are going to talk about this very popular infinity pendant. Are you ready? Let's get started. We are going to start in building a curve. You could do more spontaneous way by drawing a curve like this way and then turn on this for the adjustment, but I would like to have something really symmetrical. So this is the way I will do it. I will use the ellipse tool, turn on my grid snap because I want everything symmetrical and they will be following the construction plan. So once I have that, I'm going to mirror that to the other side. Okay, so we need to have an opening right here. Just gonna use a circle tool to draw something like roughly where that opening is going to be, and then I'm gonna use that to trim the middle off, right? So once we have done that, we can use the blend tool to blend the curve from this point to that point, and you will have this window right here, and we're going to blend one more time from here to here. Okay, all right. One of the problem you're going to have is because it's infinite, and if we join all of them, it's going to be continue a piece, right? And then so when we are turning this into the solid, for example, if I just simply just pipe it, you're going to see is the form is intersect into itself, and we cannot bowling this and you won't able to print, right? So we need to do a little bit adjustment by split this one with the point on this end and on this end, right? So they are become like two separate one. For example, if I just go ahead to pull those point up like this, it will look like a bump there. So we need to make sure that the curve that we have is a continual one, right? So what we wanted to do is rebuild both of them at the same time since it's symmetrical. So we want to use the command rebuild. In the rebuild, you're going to have this dialog coming up. We want to rebuild as last point as possible, but still maintain the shape. So I'm going to change to 8 and let's take a look. So now we have this one. I can simply just bring the one on the top. Let's move it up a little bit. And you can see this is really smooth move. Okay, so now what we wanted to do is to create a profile with the corny corners. Rectangle, and we're gonna snapping into the center in the option, and then we're gonna go to the endpoint. Let's come over here at the front, and we are going to set it roughly about 2 millimeter. It depends on how big of a stone you want to set it in there. Okay, so that's one. Since this is symmetrical, we're just gonna mirror to the other side over there. All right, so let's do a test there. We are going to have this one, and let's go ahead to use the command for sweep one rail going from here to here, and make sure they both align and in the same direction. Okay, so that will be the one, and this one we're going to use this cross section and this cross section, and there will be something like this, right? So now we have this on the top. We need to make sure they both cap, so both have become solid right there, and then we were able to join them, and then we were able to bowling them. So that's hit bowling unit, right? So now we have the shape over here. To do the stone setting, we'll need to find out the area we are going to put the stone in there. So I'm going to use the command, it's called ExtractlsoCurve. And we are going to pick up this surface right there, and somewhere in the middle is where we want to have a stone to sit on, right? So this is where the stone is going to sit on, so that will be the curve. I'm going to turn into the red color there, and then we are going to know like how long is this curve by pick up the curve and use a command called length, and this 33.138. So let's create a curve. 33.138, and then we hit enter, so we'll get this curve here. This curve is represent if this one stretch completely, and then that's how it's become. And we are going to call in the stone that we did before in other tutorial, and I will put the link there on the side, so you will know how to build a stone and how to build a prong. So now we have the stone sitting in there. I want to make sure it's aligned perfectly, so let's use the align horizontal. So then we have something there. Okay, on the top view, I want to move a little bit higher. This line right here is represent the surface, so depends how tall you want your stone sit in, right? So now we have something like this. We're simply just gonna use the linear array, and depends on how many stone you want it. I'm just guessing about 15 stone, and I want them to go like this. Get it as close as possible that you don't want it touching. All right, so now let's group all those 15 stone, make them align in the center, so something like this. Okay, now this is the stone we're going to flow it back to this curve right there. So we are going to use the command is under the transform. We have flow along the curve, pick up the object, and this is where the base curve and this is the target curve. So then you will see the stone flowing on the top of the location, and you can cut the seat for it for the stone sit better. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like and share and comment, and that I can reach more people like you who want to learn Rhino. Thank you, and I will see you next time.